actor? I love that question. What's important to the actor is that you bring yourself 100% to the work, so that we experience when we watch you on screen what I call the pop. So we don't see an actor trying to be a role. The actor is the role. So I don't really love the word character, because I feel like it keeps what you're doing away from you. And what makes your work unique is that is you bringing yourself 110% to the role. It takes commitment, it takes honesty, and it takes a lot of dedication.
You are the shield about us, delivering us from harm. Though 10,000 fall at our right hand, we find safety.
Custom setup, right? Custom motion.
You guys, normally just like the director and the producer.
Oh, okay.
I think sometimes the editor, but...
But we don't think it's going to work.
Come on, Mike, let's see it.
Good? Yeah, right. Sounded good.
One more test shot.
Hold on a second, Mike. Hold up right there for just a second. No, come on, come on.
Come through the bedroom door.
Stop right there. Okay. Stop for just a second, please. Come forward.
Okay.
Right there, stop. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome, sir.
Let's see if I can get Andy. Watch out, baby. Focus. Thank you, sir. Got it. Okay, one more walk, please. Yeah, come out of the bedroom. Go all the way back in the bedroom and okay. Come out. Okay. And action.
Because, you know, there are a couple of things that we need to practice on the camera thing. This time, I don't want you to stand up when we do that. I want him to go to the door. But that's, you know, because I'm going to do extreme close-ups of you when you're at the door. That's going to be a different setup. And then you're going to turn around and say, what if I just go to the police?
So where do you want me to do that? At my mark, maybe?
Yeah, back at your mark.
At my mark, turn around and say, hey.
And you're just going to lean forward in your desk.
Okay.
And say it that way.
Okay, shoot his angle. That will get through with the set.
Mm-hmm. That's the one. Yeah, those close-ups are already in the list.
Except
for that last part.
Yeah.
Because I wanted to do that. Sit down real quick.
Okay.
Get him standing up.
Okay. There you go. Let's see if that
looks
good.
Yeah.
There, over here.
You got it.
To meet Mark.
Okay. Okay, and...
Sleeping, the assistant's sleeping. You have a client.
Hi.
Hey, Scott, how's it going, man?
Good.
So what are y'all doing?
Just getting our lighting set up.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's all about the lighting.
It's all about the lights.
The background. Anthony Rodriguez and Scott Frank on the set here. Getting ready for our actors for headshots.
You're comfortable in?
Well, yeah, and then this is actually... I don't know how useful that would be.
No.
I'm putting this t-shirt underneath that.
Yeah.
And that's good.
See what this ensemble like this. I like this ensemble.
Could I shoot the denim too? Would you mind? Or I need a denim one, so I have a denim and it's, I don't like my face.
Okay, let's are you wrapped upstairs? Let me first get a couple shots of you real quick. And then we'll come back, we'll do a couple shots of the denim, and I also need a piece of paper too, so, and a pen, because I need to write everybody's name down.
Yeah, it's exciting. So they're setting up for your daughter's scene in the playroom there.
Ben.
Katie, can I get your assistant to just touch me up here real quick?
Absolutely.
I'm going to do my headshot.
Okay.
Experience. So you've already, y'all already rehearsed the script and the scenes that were written by Norman Ray Fitz. And
right.
He actually did a custom story for y'all, so he's really talented. I guess, what was that process like?
It was exciting. Caroline and Ben work really well together, and Joanna was excited that they could, that they both wanted to do this and could work together, and I think they're going to be great
Hi.
At it.
Hi. I'm going to be, I'll be the director.
Are you Nelson? It's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Finally in person, yes.
Phone a few times.
I'm not wearing makeup. Don't get me on camera.
Oh, you're,
I know.
You're
all, yeah. It's like I didn't fix myself up. I just worried about her, so.
Uh-oh. But y'all look great.
Unfortunately.
You can go through. You can go through.
Oh, I can go through? Yeah. I got it.
So,
on you, man. We take you out, your family. Norman Ray Fitz for Joanna Sanchez Entertainment, and we're here with Roscoe Lynn. And the name of your character you play in this particular story?
Mr. Richard Betterman.
All right, that was an awesome scene that you did just a while ago, which we're going to be able to share with everyone. But tell us what it was like studying for that role, and what you brought to the table to make it work.
It was really a good role, interesting character, had a good partner, and. Things worked out really, really well. Wasn't that hard to prepare for. Yesterday, I got together with Joanna, and she helped me through those scenes. Worked out really good.
In that role, you're in financial trouble with a very sinister character played by Tommy Pointner, Mr. Starkey. So what's...
I think I got in a little gambling trouble. Owed a lot of money, and Mr. Starkey wanted his money. And I, you know, in the back of my mind, had to figure out a way, how am I going to come up with this $252,000 that I owed?
Oh, man. So aren't you glad you're not really in that position?
That's right. That's right.
Well, thank you so much. You're getting ready to take your character shot with the photographer, Scott Frank. We're really glad that you're in, yes, in your wardrobe already and ready to go.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for participating.
Right.
He plays Mr. Starkey, a sinister character in the movie Memories, written by Norman Ray Fitz, screenwriter. We're participating in Joanna Sanchez Entertainment Actors Enrichment course this weekend. And thank you, Tommy, for participating. I want to have a few words about your character. Y'all just completed the scene. Definitely was very powerful, your delivery opposite Roscoe Lynn. So tell us a bit about how you prepared for the character and a little bit of your appreciation for the story, Memories.
Well, I really put myself into the mindset of the character. I created the props that we used and thought about, you know, what the issues were with the other actor. And so he's a pretty sinister guy. He's almost a smart aleck in some cases. He's so cocky and so powerful, but he loses his temper periodically, and he's a pretty bad guy. But in this particular scenario, he wanted a certain thing, and so we stayed focused on what he actually wanted to accomplish, and so we worked really hard to make sure that we stayed on track with that. But it was a real fun character to play. You get to kind of do a range of emotions and a range of personality reflections, so it was a lot of fun to do it.
And you're actually doing this under the weather a little bit, so you're having to pick up...
I'm not feeling 100% here. I got a little bit of a cold in my voice, so that became part of the character. That was his accent.
And you're doing whatever it takes to make it happen. That's really great. It's been a pleasure to work with you. You're getting ready to take your updated headshot with photographer Scott Frank, so we're looking forward to seeing that. And thank you again for participating.
Okay, it was a lot of fun to do that. Appreciate it.
Did you want the door like kind of closed or no?
No, just open.
And like that? Is that good? Like an off?
Yeah. Okay. Let me see. Yeah. Because he's...
Rehearsing quiet on the set.
You start to really miss him. Just look up and tell him you love him and you miss him. Trust me, he'll hear you. There's this dog adoption thing going on at the park. Do you think
you're gonna cut? We need a star alerted right towards the bed. That's a little too much. A little bit back.
Thank you.
All right, maybe like edge along the edge of the bed. Yeah, but up against the bed. All right, like face her, like lean in just a little bit. All right, so maybe like when you get up,
lip tone, so that when we put the lip liner and lipstick on.
Yeah. Oh wow. I would never think to do that.
Hi, yeah. How you doing?
Great. Should I go ahead?
You guys want to rehearse a few times while we clean? To final touches, makeup, and the rest of your jewelry. Director, can we get to
okay?
Okay.
No.
Okay, what do you want?
Yes.
The veto.
Yeah. Yeah. All right.
That's my girl, girl. See, I got it.
All right, good morning. We're in the makeup room.
Good morning.
With Katie, Elsie Elrod, and actor... Roscoe?
Yeah, Elise.
Oh, sorry.
Katie Elise. No,
Elise.
That's okay.
I gotta put it in there.
It's
Katie
an old-fashioned name. We've got Roscoe here. We're applying his foundation.
Looking good, Roscoe.
Yeah. Got a good match. He's gonna look like himself.
We got Kayla Valdez assisting.
Yeah, and she's learning there and watching what I'm doing, and she's been cleaning brushes for me already, keeping our system going here.
Awesome. Getting some behind the scenes here.
Mm-hmm. Never forget the ears.
The real world of make believe, going behind the curtain.
Yep.
Well, we got to.
Did you know that God drinks coffee? It's called Hebrews. Good morning.
Good morning, Mike Morales. He's going to be our camera operator today.
Shabbat Shalom. Good morning.
Thank you. Good morning.
Can't wait to groove.
And we got our craft set up here for early morning set. Well, there's the proprietor, Miss Victoria.
And
Before actor Victoria Nichols, who's hosting us.
I look like a kid without no makeup.
Well, we have makeup station if you need to.
That's what I was talking about with Joanna. She said that would be fine. But if you already
rehearsed
it, then...
Oh, yeah, we had fun with this here. We had a real smart ass. Have a nice day.
Okay, well, then we'll do it.
Yeah, just behind the scenes with Tommy Pointer, the actor, and the director, Steffi Grace. Howdy, everybody. Good morning. Morning.
No, this is all wrong.
This is...
Change it.
Can I put the script off? That's not
I've already put that Harvey Klein shot scene yet. But I've been an extra in it, so... And I did wardrobe and stuff, so...
And a lot of it, it's taking... A lot of stuff is taking place right now.
I sort of
is leaning towards what the world will become in my story. It will be a single factor control the entire planet. The U.S. in Canada. They have since taken the border between them and made one country out of it. We're the only bastion of free thought left in the world. So then they decided to just get rid of us. So they used a biological missile attack to wipe out the population.
So that's quite interesting.
Right.
I'm just doing some behind the scenes.
Hey Andy, is that the audio? Hello Andy.
Just here doing some behind the scenes. Hey Hector, how you doing? You're chatting with Katie, Elise Elrod. That's it. How y'all doing? So what's going on, man?
Okay. Elise, okay.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I think I've heard your name somewhere.
Oh,
cool. Well, I remember the Elrod.
Katie,
yeah,
Elise.
Yeah.
Elrod. How do you get that right? Practice.
Yeah.
And you're heading out to go get
people shake your hand and say, I'm a screenwriter. You get into talking about all the screenplays you've written, all of this you've done, and it's all about me. And that's not networking. Building relationships, meaning you're focusing on the other person. So you want to get to ask them, what do you do? If you want to do that, after you start a dinner.